So an obvious better idea is just what's referred to as mean filtering. Mean is my background now, instead of just being the last frame, which seems really silly, is just going to be the average of the last n frames. That's what it says here. Right? My background at time t is just the average of the sum of n frames in the past. Okay. In which case, then my background, my mask is now, I take my current image, subtract off that mean, and then is it greater than a threshold? Notice we now have a new parameter, right? We now have this parameter n. We have to worry about how much do we average. So here's an example on the same scene of using n as n equal 10, all right? So it's average. Now you'll see it's kind of a weird thing, right? So this van that has, you know, kind of blended in there, right, as it averages over different places, and my foreground mask looks kind of like this, all right? And so I'm getting this extension of the cars in a variety of ways, and it's not so great. And the reason that it's not so great is that the average isn't really the right thing, right? So averaging over all those vans is getting me this kind of weird thing, right? Now, of course, if I had averaged over 50, you know, but then I'd have all these other cars coming through, the average is very sensitive to this. What you can think of is that the background is just sort of a constant value with maybe a little variation, and occasionally I get some random perturbation, right? Some random noise comes along. We've seen this before. Remember when we were doing noise filtering of images, and we were using Gaussians, et cetera, and then we put in that like salt and pepper noise, and we said salt and pepper noise, the problem with it is every now and then you get this big spike in there, and an average will get torqued around quite a bit by that. So what was the solution to that? The solution to that was to use a median.